Shalom, my bitches. Myandis here at NFY, bringing you the story of Drake McDougal by 4chan user Plainfag. About 12 years ago, a man died in high orbit above Tau Ceta 5. His name was Drake McDougal, and aside from a few snapshots and vague anecdotes from his drinking buddies, that's probably all we'll ever know about him. Another colony-born man with little records and little documentation, working whatever asteroid field the Draks deigned to allow them. Every now and then, a Drak gunship would strut on through the system, Pax Draconia and all that. But that was it. One fine day, one of those gunships had a misjump. A bad one. It arrived only 90 clicks above Atmo, with all of its impilers blown out by the gravitic feedback of Tau Ceta 5's gravity well. The Drak scraped enough power together for a good system-wide broadbeam, and were already beginning the death chant when they hit Atmo. People laughed at the recording of 60 Draks going from mysterious chanting to what the fucking for years after they forgot the name Drake McDougal. The deafening clang and split second of stunned silence afterwards never failed to entertain. Drake had performed a hasty re-entry after the gunship and partially slagged his heat shield diving after it. Experts later calculated he suffered 11 Gs when he leaned on the retro to match velocities with the Draks, long enough to engage the mag grapples on his little mining tug. Even the massively overpowered drive of a tug has its limits, though, and Drake's little ship hit hers about 1.5 minutes later. Pushed too far, the tug's fusion plant lost containment just as he finished slingshotting the gunship into low orbit. It was unharmed, of course. The Drak opinion of fusion power best translates as quaint, kind of how we view butter churns. It was on the local news within hours, on news nets across human space within days. It was discussed, memorialized, marveled upon, chewed over by daytime talk hosts. And I think somebody even bought a plaque or some shit like that. Then there was a freighter accident, and a mass shooting on Orbital 5, and of course, the first Vandal attacks in the periphery. The galaxy moved on. 12 years is a long time, especially during war. So 12 years later, as the Vandals' main fleet was jumping in near Jupiter, and we were strapping into the crash couches of what we enthusiastically called warships, I guarantee you that not one man in the entire Defense Force could remember who Drake McDougal was. Well, the Draks sure as hell did. Draks do not fuck around. Dozens of 2-kilometer-long Drak supercaps jumped in barely 90 kiloclicks away, and then we just stood around staring at our displays like the slack-jawed apes we were as we watched what a real can of galactic whoop-ass looked like. You could actually see the atmosphere of Jupiter roil occasionally when a Vandal ship happened to cross between it and the Drak fleet. There's still lightning storms on Jupiter now. Something about residual heavy ions and excess static charges or something. 58 hours later, with every Vandal ship reduced to slag debris and 9 wounded Drak ships spinning about as they vented atmosphere, they started with the broadband chanting again. And then, the communique that confused the hell out of all of us. Do you hold our debts fulfilled? After the 6th or 7th comms officer told them, we don't know what the hell you're talking about, as politely as possible, the Drak fleet commander got on the horn and asked to speak to a human admiral in roughly the same tone as a telemarketer telling a kid to give the phone to daddy. When the admiral didn't know either, the Drak went silent for a minute. And when he came back on, his translator was using much smaller words and talking slower. Is the blood debt to Drake McDougal's clan now satisfied? The admiral said, who? What the Drak commander said next would have caused a major diplomatic incident had he remembered to revert to the more complex translation protocols. He thought the admiral must be an idiot, a coward, or both. Eventually, the diplomats were called out, and we were asked why the human race had largely forgotten the sacrifice of Drake McDougal. Humans, we explained, sacrifice themselves all the time. We trotted out every news clip from the space-wide nets from the last 12 years. Some freighter cook that fell on a grenade during a pirate raid on Outreach. A ship engineer who locked himself into the reactor room and kept containment until the crew evacuated. A firefighter who died shielding a child from falling debris with his body during an earthquake. Stuff like that. The Drax were utterly stunned. Their diplomats wandered out of the conference room in a daze. We just told them that the rarest, most selfless, and honorable of acts, acts that incurred generation-long blood debts and moved entire fleets, was so routine for our species that they were bumped off the news by the latest celebrity scandal. Everything changed for humanity after that, and it was all thanks to a single tug pilot who taught the galaxy what truly defines man. Alright, I hope y'all enjoyed that one. If you did, go ahead and leave me a subscribe, a comment, a thumbs up, all of that shiznaz. And if you didn't, let me know. I'm trying to improve, do all those good things better. And yeah, have a nice one, y'alls. Also, if you couldn't tell, I moved into a new place, and so I need to work out the acoustics of my recording arrangement. There's a lot more echo in here than my previous place. So, yeah.